In this video, how to revive dried out acrylic paint, how to rehydrate the dried acrylic paint in your paint tubes. Welcome to the I Love to Paint channel. This is your artsy friend, Martha. If you're an art inclined and love acrylic painting tutorials, this is your channel. Some quick tips on restoring dried out paint so you can restore, rehydrate, revive, and reuse your old dried acrylic paints. How many times I have been in the middle of a painting and then suddenly the next paint color that I want to use, you have seen me sometimes in the videos, I try to pour the next color and nothing happens because it's dry. The first thing you need to do when you want to restore or reuse one of these acrylic paint bottles, the trick is to check first with your finger and see how hard it is. If it doesn't even stain you, if it is completely dried out and plastified, may as well, you know, get rid of it because it will hardly be worth all the work. However, if it is your favorite color, try to remove all the old, dry, hardened paint out of the place, because what you're going to be doing is out of the three ways that I'm going to show here in this video, the simplest is add water. If it is just slightly dried like this one, that I know if I shake it, which is the first way of doing things, and by the way, this one is pretty wet and creamy, it's just slightly dried out. We moved, and unfortunately, a lot of my paint was in storage, and this is what happens. They just get dried. So the first way of trying, after you realize that it does indeed has still a chance, if it is completely plastified, as I said, just don't, you know, go and get another one. But if it is still wet, just too thick, what you do is, with some little bit of water, I'm going to use this just simply because I have it for my pets. You could get one at the pet supplies shop, but anyway, I just will use it. I could do it with a tinier little cup or something. I just want to use this because I have it handy and because it is small. So add literally 3 drops. And then get a wet paintbrush from the back, because like this one, for example, I just refinished it. It was all stiff and ugly. If you want to see the video, I will have it over here when I have it ready. I just cleaned it very nicely. But if you use the back of the brush, you save yourself the trouble of re-cleaning. So with your wet brush, go behind, mix, mix, mix. 30 minutes later, you're still mixing, but it will work. Once it's more flexible or wet, hydrated, you can start shaking it. If you don't want to waste this paint in a napkin, what you can do is smearing it in your art journal, which is what I'm going to be doing because I love stained pages and then work on them. So I'll be right back. If you like this content, if you think it helps, share it with a friend. Anyway, that was the first method, which is like the simplest of everything, right? You just add water, mix with a brush. If the paint is a little thicker, you add, this is the second little hack, you add your few drops of water. And then you use a product like this, which is an extender medium for having more time for the paint to dry. I'm going to get, with my other little gizmo here, just a couple of drops. Let's try with 2, and we close it because we don't want to make a mess. And this is where the thing goes again back into mixing it little by little. If this part that I'm seeing here is too dry, what I'm going to do is getting it out with the brush. I could smear it on a page, but I don't want to take the time right now. What I wanted to say after adding my little water too is that a while back, this is where things get really interesting. A while back, somebody gave us this thing in a gift exchange, and I thought not much of it. However, when I saw this part over here, I thought, the size seems to be perfect for this thing. So we're going to try. I'm going to wet it. It just mixes, literally. So what I'm going to be doing is probably with a little bit more water, because it is really, really, really dried out. We're going to test it. If you want to check it out, I'm going to have a link in the information box below. Also, same for the medium. I have a couple of links for them. Right now we can see it's a lot creamier. So things are going well. I'm going to keep mixing it for a while. Since this is craft paint, and I literally just use it for my art journal, which is paper, I don't care about the percentage of water mix and acrylic paint, because it's not going to go anywhere except for my art journal. If I was to be going to be painting on canvas, number one, I would be preventing the drying by storing my paints like this and not letting them into very dry or extreme cold weather stored for a long time like that. The function of acrylic paint is to dry as plastic and last for a long time. So if you leave it like that in the bottle, it's going to have to be doing the same thing, only that instead of an art, just in the bottle. Anyway, this is the other way. The only thing that I noticed that is not going to be working on is on these skinny openings of some paint bottles, because this acrylic paint is, the bottle is different. And for the tube, what can be done is, well, if you can see this one kind of, I don't know if you can see, but it's kind of like stiff in there. I know if I squeeze it, it's going to come out and I can paint, but it should be a little bit more liquid. So what I'm going to be doing again is just to drop a couple of drops of water, a little bit of my medium, and shake. It's gonna be shaken for a long time until everything mixes, but the result will be again juicy, nice, rehydrated paint, because what we want is to restore the paint so we can reuse it and revive it and give those bottles a new life on your acrylic paint. Once you're done with this, you have to take it to a place, some water, where you're not going to be using for human consumption. You're just going to be using it for your crafts. Give it a good rinse. And if you're new here, I would love for you to subscribe and check this playlist over here with more art hacks and lots of painting and artsy fun.